So, it's 2019. Avengers Endgame is coming out in 3 weeks. Next month, Godzilla King of the Monsters is being released, and in the winter, Star Wars Episode 9 will be hitting the big screen. All of these films are part of an established franchise, but they're more than just that. They're perfect examples of transmedia storytelling. As American media scholar Henry Jenkins puts it, transmedia storytelling represents a process where integral elements of a fiction get dispersed systemically across multiple delivery channels for the purpose of creating a unified and coordinated entertainment experience. The films I just mentioned all have comic book, video game, and book tie-ins that add more to their stories. It's essentially the practice that Hollywood has been partaking in for the past 10 years or so. But I want to take you guys back, way back, to 1997, when video game company Rare released Goldeneye for the Nintendo 64 and put in transmedia storytelling in the mainstream light. So for those of you that don't know, Goldeneye the game is based on the 1995 film Goldeneye. It's the 17th installment in the James Bond franchise and the first to feature Pierce Brosnan. The film tells a story about MI6 agent 007, aka James Bond, who fights to prevent an ex-MI6 agent gone rogue from using a satellite against London to cause a global financial meltdown. The film did fantastically well critically and financially, grossing over $355 million with a $60 million budget. 2 years after the success of the film, however, Goldeneye the game was released for the Nintendo 64. On his blog, Henry Jenkins has a list of 10 points that define what a transmedia story is. I've narrowed down what I consider to be the most crucial of the 10 and applied them to Goldeneye. So let's spend the next few minutes understanding how Goldeneye became a forgotten piece of transmedia storytelling. Jenkins' first point was mentioned earlier. Transmedia storytelling is a process where integral elements of a fiction across multiple delivery channels for the purpose of creating a unified and coordinated entertainment experience. The game, for the most part, follows the film's plot pretty similarly. Some plot points were taken out of the game, and new ones were added for the sake of telling a coherent story. In the opening scene of the film, Bond is showed running on a dam and bungee jumping himself off of it. There's no mention of how he got there or the obstacles that he had to overcome to get to this destination. In the game, however, the first level shows us everything leading up to the jump. We get to experience the enemies Bond encountered, the geography of the dam, and the tedious tasks that were completed along the way. This happens throughout the entirety of Goldeneye, and it's one of the best aspects of the game in my opinion. When I recently watched the movie again, I found myself questioning how characters got from point A to point B. After playing the game though, all the questions I had about the geography of the world were answered. While the game and movie stand on their own, the game provides information to its players that enhances the viewing experience of the film when watched again. Jenkins' second point mentions that transmedia storytelling reflects the economics of media consolidation, or what industry observers call synergy. Essentially, synergy refers to the interaction or cooperation of two or more organizations, substances, and other agents to produce a combined effect greater than the sum of their separate effects. In Goldeneye's terms, the film acts as one agent, and the video game acts as the second. Because the game is based on the movie, the game advertises the film. Because there's an adaptation of the film in a game form, the film advertises the video game. With two separate versions of the story available, the profit created by the two together is far more than just a single form. At this point, I think it'd also be important to add that a short comic book series based on Goldeneye was released during the time of the film. The third point on the blog states that transmedia stories are based not on individual characters or specific plots, but rather complex fictional worlds which can sustain multiple interrelated characters and their stories. The James Bond series has a world of its own, and even in the films, not every single aspect of it can be explored. Goldeneye the game, however, adds more to this world. As I mentioned earlier, some of the film's plot was slightly changed for when it was adapted into the game. For example, in the film, two of the villains board onto a French Navy destroyer. On a small boat, Bond watches the two get away on a helicopter that was planted on the ship. The scene then ends and cuts to a different location, leaving the ship unexplored to the viewer. In the game, the plot was slightly changed so that the players could explore the Navy destroyer. On this level, Bond must roam the ship, killing enemies left and right, with an ultimate goal of planting a tracker on the helicopter. After doing so, Bond leaves the destination, and the two villains escape on the helicopter. The level adds depth to the Bond world, having us experience what it's like to be an MI6 agent and different locations in which other characters in this world wander through. More examples can be found in many of the levels in this game. In the film, a location like the bunker is only shown briefly to tell the story. We only get certain glimpses of the layout, but in the game, the plot was altered to allow players to explore the locations briefly showcased in the film. Jenkins' fourth point states that Transmedia storytelling practices may expand the potential market for a property by creating different points of entry for different audience segments. The reality is that there's always going to be people in this world who don't watch movies but who do play games, or vice versa. But that's the benefit of Transmedia storytelling. While one individual might not be interested in the Bond films, they might, however, be interested in the Bond games. Having different points of entry allows storytellers to reach a broader audience and thus creating more revenue. While Goldeneye did great at the box office, the video game also did fantastically well because it not only appealed to the Bond fanbase, but also to the typical action gamer, adults, and others whose interest was caught more by the game than that of the movie. In the fifth and final point, Jenkins states that Transmedia storytelling extensions may serve a variety of functions. While I mentioned earlier that the game and the movie basically self-promote one another, I didn't touch upon the fact that this game also acted as an advertisement for the overall James Bond series. GoldenEye the game was released on August 25th, 1997. That same year, MGM released the 18th installment in the Bond franchise, titled Tomorrow Never Dies, on December 19th, 1997. As we all know, Hollywood strategically chooses release dates to garner in as much money as possible. Because GoldenEye was based on an established franchise not owned by Nintendo, the parent company of the franchise has a say in the release date of the game. I don't think any of us can deny that releasing the game 4 months before the 18th installment of a franchise was a perfect PR move to generate interest for the next film. Now, why does this matter? Well, GoldenEye went on to be the third highest grossing game on the N64. It set the groundwork for future first-person shooter games and proved that video games could be an extension for the worlds created in other entertainment mediums. Prior to GoldenEye, game adaptations based on movies either tried to make levels out of the film's plot points or tried to tell a new story within an already established world. Those games that tried to tell new stories, however, either failed or were not commercially successful. GoldenEye put Transmedia storytelling into the mainstream light, telling the world that expanding a universe was possible. In 2006, EA released The Godfather, a game that takes place in the Godfather universe with a new storyline but with an expansion of the film world. In 2011, Telltale Games released Jurassic Park the game, taking place right after the events of the first film and allowing players to explore new parts of the theme park not explored in the movie. And in the fall of this year, EA will be releasing Star Wars Jedi Fallen Order that will take place after Star Wars Episode 3 and allow us to explore planets we've never seen before. See, GoldenEye acted as a catalyst for game designers. It encouraged them to continue telling stories in the worlds we grew to love, and taught storytellers that the complex worlds in their heads could be fully explored by the public.